Hello and welcome to my channel. What we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing, that would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video, please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time, let's get started. To create this animation, I have imported some stock files. I will leave a link in the description for the websites from which I have downloaded these stock files. Create a new composition and name it as Final. I have chosen a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. Create a new solid layer and name it as Background. Choose a color of something around dark gray and click OK. From the project panel, bring in the background image into the timeline. Search for tint effect and apply it into the background image layer. Search for curves effect and apply it into the same image file. Change the curves as shown. Using the ellipse tool, create a mask like this and feather it a bunch to create a vignette effect. Also use the mask expansion for further tuning. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in cinematic trailer. Design your text as you wish. Center align the text and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as text placeholder and click OK. Make sure you click on move all attributes before clicking OK. Press S to bring up the scale property and increase the scale value. Create a new solid layer and name it as fractal. Search for fractal noise from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the fractal solid layer. Search the fractal type to turbulent sharp. In the transform settings, uncheck the uniform scaling and set the scale width to 500 and set the scale height to 10,000. Set the contrast to 200 and the brightness to -100. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for evolution. At the end of the timeline, set the evolution value to 2. Now right click the fractal solid layer and click on pre-compose. Name the pre-comp as reference and click on move all attributes and click OK. Move the text placeholder above the reference layer. Change the track mat of reference layer to alpha mat text placeholder. Duplicate the text placeholder composition and bring that below the reference layer. Now turn on the visibility of the duplicated layer. Search for fill effect and apply it into the duplicated layer. Set the color to black and click OK. Search for drop shadow effect and apply it into the duplicated layer. Set the opacity to 100% and the distance to 40 and softness to 80. Search for bevel alpha from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the same layer. Set the edge thickness to 4 and the light intensity to 1. Duplicate the drop shadow effect. Search for CC glass effect and apply it into the first text placeholder. Open the surface property and set the softness to 40. Set the height to 20 and set the displacement to 500. Open up the light property and set the light type to point light. Search for CC blobless effect and apply it into the same layer. Open up the blobiness property and set the property to alpha. Set the softness to 10 and cut away to 50. Open up the light property and set the light type to point light. Now select all the layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Create a new adjustment layer and rename it to glow. Search for glow effect and apply it into the adjustment layer. Set the glow intensity to 2 and glow radius to 100. The glow is not as I have wished. Open up the reference composition and select the fractal solid layer and set the contrast value to 250. Change the evolution value at the end of the timeline to 1. Go to the final comp layer and create a new adjustment layer. Rename it to sharpen and search for sharpen effect and apply it into the sharpen adjustment layer. Set the sharpen amount to 20. Now go to the project panel and bring in the light file into the timeline. I want this light to be coming from above, so right click and click on transform and choose flip vertical. And now use the pen tool and create a mask like this. Set the blending mode to add. Feather the mask to around 500. Set the opacity value to 30. Bring in the particles file from the project panel into the timeline and scale it down to fit the composition. Set the opacity value to 50 and change the blending mode to add. Create a new adjustment layer and name it as blue. Search for curves effect and apply it into the blue adjustment layer. Now change the graph as shown. Change the opacity value to 50%. Open up the pre-comp layer and select the first three layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as text. Press S to bring up the scale property. At the start of the timeline, set the value to 80% and create a keyframe. At the end of the timeline, set the scale value to 100%. Go to the final comp layer and search for turbulent displace effect and apply it into the pre-comp layer. Set the displacement to turbulent smoother. In order to create wave-like effect, we are going to use wiggle expression. Wiggle, open bracket, 0.5, 5, close bracket. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for the evolution with the default value, and at the end of the timeline, set the evolution value to 1. Particle file, right click, click on time and choose time stretch. In the new duration, set the value to that of the composition length. Create a new solid layer and name it as frame. Make sure the solid is of black color. With the solid selected, double click on the rectangle tool to create a mask. In the mask path, click on shape and set the top value to 12 and the bottom value to 88. Click on the inverted checkbox. Now create a new null object and bring it down below the frame layer. Select all other layers below the null layer and parent them to the null one layer. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for scale value, and at the end of the timeline, set the scale value to 120. Now RAM preview this. That's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.